I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today's concept is about kinematics of machine. In this one, analysis, analytical synthesis of four bar mechanism, Fredston equation. Let us consider a four bar mechanism, x axis and y axis, A, B, C, D, where here it makes an angle theta with the x axis. This makes an angle phi with x axis. And this makes an angle beta with the x-axis. Next, we are going for the length A, B, C and D. It is a closed loop. AD is the fixed length. These are the angle theta, beta, phi. Now, let us resolve this one horizontally and vertically. We will resolve it horizontally and vertically in this way. Resolve it horizontally and vertically. Now, if the arrow is this direction, this arrow will be here in this direction. If it is here and here, you have to follow. Next arrow will be here. If the arrow is here, the next arrow will be here as it follows. Next arrow will be here. This arrow is here. Therefore, this arrow will be here. It forms in this way. In this way. Let us resolve in x direction. X direction. That is, resolve it x direction. How to resolve? A cos theta and y direction. A sin theta. B cos beta. This one B sin beta. Now this part C sin phi. This part C cos phi. Cos phi. We have resolved it here. Horizontal and vertical. Now, next, along the x direction, only the x terms we are going to consider here. That is, only x here, positive, positive, negative, negative. Now, arrow is here, it is positive. Therefore, A cos theta, only x terms along the x axis. Now, this term plus B cos beta because arrow is this direction. Next, here minus, the arrow is the direction, minus C cos phi. One more arrow is here, minus D is equal to 0. You can write B cos beta is equal to, you have to bring this side, it becomes C cos phi minus A cos theta plus D. Squaring the above equation, it becomes B square cos square beta, and this term becomes C cos phi minus A cos theta plus D whole square. Here you have to apply the formula, mathematical formula. That is, this is the mathematical formula you have to apply. A plus B plus C whole square is nothing but A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB plus 2AC plus 2BC. You have to apply this formula. This becomes A, B and C. Now, let us resolve. B square cos square beta is equal to C square cos square phi plus A square cos theta square plus D square plus minus 2ab. This is a, this is b, therefore 2ac cos phi cos theta. Next 2ac, this is a and c, plus 2cd cos phi plus 2abc. BC is nothing but bc and c. This will become minus ad cos theta. Equation 1. Now, about y-axis, we have resolved along the y-axis. We have to equate to 0 here. Y, a sin theta, positive. Next, this part, plus b sin beta. Next, this wire is downward, minus c sin phi is equal to 0. B sin beta is equal to c sin phi minus a sin theta. Squaring above equation, you have to square it. B square sin square beta is equal to c sin phi minus a sin theta whole square. Use this mathematical formula. A minus b whole square is nothing but a square plus b square minus 2ab. Use this formula here. B square sin square beta is equal to c square sin square phi plus a square sin square theta minus 2ac sin phi sin theta. Equation 2. Equate 1 and 2. B square, take B square common, cos square beta plus sin square beta is equal to this and this term, take C as common, C square, again cos square phi plus sin square phi. Next, A square, make it A square common, cos square theta plus sin square theta plus d square. Now minus, now this and this term I will take minus 2ac common, cos phi cos theta plus sin phi into sin theta, this and this. Next, plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta. This becomes 1, because sin square theta into plus cos square theta is nothing but 1. And this term becomes what? This term, I will write here on other sheet. I'll keep here. It becomes B square is equal to C square plus A square plus D square minus 2AC, and this becomes cos phi minus D theta. Cos phi minus theta is nothing but cos phi cos theta plus sin phi. sine theta. This becomes this term. Plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta. Cos theta. I'll bring this side here. A square minus b square plus c square plus d square. I'll bring this whole term on that side plus these two term as it is plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta is equal to 2ac cos phi minus theta. Phi minus theta. Divide 2ac on either direction. It becomes a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ac plus 2cd cos phi divided by 2ac. 2ac minus 2ad cos theta divided by 2ac. 2ac cos phi minus theta divided by 2ac. This and this cancel. A and A cancel. 2 cancel. C cancel. 2 cancel. Here further it can be written as a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ac. Plus d by a cos phi minus d by c cos theta is equal to cos phi minus theta. Phi minus theta. Further, let K3 will be a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ac. K1 will be d divided by a. K2 will be minus d divided by c. Now substitute these values here. It becomes K3 plus K1 cos phi. K1 cos phi plus K2. Cos theta is equal to cos phi minus theta. Rewrite the equation. K1 cos phi plus K2 cos theta plus K3 is equal to cos phi minus theta. This equation we call as a Fredestein equation for the four bar mechanism. Further, if it is a three position synthesis, further this is called the Fredestein equation. Okay, this completes your Fredestein equation. Now three position synthesis. Here what happened, this is a general equation we obtained it. If it is a three position synthesis for the four bar mechanism, let us consider in this way. Fixed link here. This is link A, B1, and one more is here. This is C1, which makes an angle theta 1, phi 1. Cut an arc here in this way. The next link will be here. The position will be here. This will be phi 2. This will be theta 2. One more. This will be phi 3, sorry, phi 3, and this will be theta 3. This will be B1, this will be B2, C1, C2, B3, C3. This diagram we call it the three position synthesis. That means the formula becomes phi 1 theta 1 for this one it becomes phi 2 theta 2 for this part this becomes phi 3 theta 3 and you have to convert into matrix form in order to find out the k1 k2 and k3 value. By using that one you can find out the length A, B and C and D. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.